Hi everybody, it's Luke from Neckog Industries, and if you're part of the Kickstarter, you should have received a phone call from me or one of our team members letting you know the latest on your Flovv orders. If you're out of the loop, the gist of it is that during stress testing, we discovered a slight tolerance issue from our gear manufacturer, which resulted in us not being able to pump out high viscosity materials like we had originally planned for. To address this issue, we decided to switch manufacturers to a local aerospace company, which did set us back about 6 weeks. So we're starting order deliveries in mid-April of this year. We want to sincerely apologize to everybody who's been patiently waiting, but we wanted to fully meet the expectations we had originally set out for. We redesigned Flovv's front cover for a new sleek look, we've updated the user interface, and we have a few cool new features that I'd like to show you in this video. So let's get into it and inject some flexible polyurethane. We already have a video on our channel showing how to make your own silicone molds, so I'll get right into injection. We've had many requests to see an application for flexible material. Flexible polyurethane is used in everything from shoes to furniture to automotive parts. I made these molds for furniture corner protectors and doorstops. Using our variable speed function, I've turned down the flow rate to ensure perfect injection. With thinner parts, it's important to err on the side of caution by injecting slower as to avoid bubbles accidentally catching on the walls of the mold. This flexible material has a shore hardness of 50A, which is about the same flexibility as a pencil eraser and a little less flexible than a car tire. Depending on what your intended use is, you'll want to do a bit of research to decide on your shore hardness, and we can help you with that. You can email support@neckog.com for questions about your projects. On top of being highly versatile, flexible polyurethane resists abrasion and chemicals, making your final products extremely tough and resistant to wear and tear. It was great to hear about all the different applications everyone's planning to use the machine for. We had prosthetics, construction, agriculture. A few people were machinists who are going to CNC their own molds and use Flovv instead of hand pouring. I talked to someone who's making parts for robotic automation, a hotel manager who needs a solution stronger than 3D printing but just as cost effective, someone making anatomical bone and muscle structure, 3D print farmers who want to make their operation more efficient, a cosplay creator, and tons of people who are using it for artistic purposes or simply to get more familiar with polyurethanes. Since this is an open face mold, I like to put something on top to get a nice even surface upon demolding, and for this I'm using a sheet protector from the office and a piece of plexiglass to flatten out the excess material. Flexible polyurethanes typically have a longer pot life than rigid polyurethanes. You have about 8 minutes of pour time for this material. We include a silicone mat with every machine to catch any material that you might spill. It's always better to let the material harden, then remove it from the mat. Demolding time is recommended for an hour, then we can pop our parts out of the mold. The sheet protectors easily peel off, leaving us with a level top surface. I didn't use any mold release paste or spray for these parts, and since the silicone molds transfer every minute detail, you may see some layer lines on our flexible parts since we use 3D printed parts to make our mold. But this is dependent on if you decide to post-process your 3D prints before you make the molds, or if you decide to use 3D printed parts at all. Basically, anything you see on your master part, that's what you're going to see on your produced parts. We also include a set of mold prying tools with each machine, but with silicone molds, it's a lot easier to remove without the use of the tools. But they're nice to have on hand and useful for one of our new features we recently implemented. I'll show you what I mean after we demold these parts. Our design team is constantly working on customer molds and new features for our machines, so if you have any suggestions about what you'd like to see next or parts you want us to try for future videos, feel free to leave a comment. If you're curious about where you can order a machine and materials, check out our shop at store.neckog.com or follow the link in the description of this video. The duty cycle for a silicone mold is usually around 100 cycles for simpler parts like these doorstops and corner protectors, and about 30 cycles for more complicated parts. Each mold will vary. But what if I wanted to change materials from flexible to rigid or foam? Wouldn't it be great if you could just swap the tanks? Oh yeah. One of the features we've implemented was requested mid-Kickstarter, which is the quick tank swap. This resulted in needing to change about 30% of our machine design, plus designing a new board, and it took about 4 weeks of testing just to make sure the machine was durable and worked as intended, but man, was it worth it. You can easily swap tanks to use different materials on the same machine. Due to our onboard cleaning system, there's no risk of cross-contamination. I clamp the tubing to ensure no leaks, and use one of our demolding tools to remove the tubing from the pump body. It's that easy. These demolding tools and clamps are available on our website.
We also have spare tanks and a variety of materials you can use with the machine. After I swap the tanks, I can remove the clamps from the tubing, and just like that, we can inject a different kind of material with the same machine. It's that quick.
That's all I've got for today. Thank you so much for your ongoing support. We're almost there. We also have some exciting announcements we're going to talk about later this year. So stay tuned and thank you for watching.